Hello, everybody. This is Andrew for Game Zone. We got Rei II here, and we just entered the No Man's Wharf. So let's start our adventure. We're pumped. We're human. We're ready to go. We got a new area. That guy's sleeping. That guy. Yeah, we're not going to fall for that, Dark Souls. We're immune to your tricks. We are mighty. We are strong. We are... We are now hollow. All right, well, this area is dark, and so there's actually slightly... ledges you can fall into that allegedly have water that will instantly kill you. So Rei II's not... she's looking a little green. We could use another effigy, because as you know, I want to be human as much as possible. I want to get invaded. I want to experience that. But let's get a little through this area first. I'm going to go recover. I'm going to run past the dead guy or the sleeping guy. You die once in this game and it just gets in your head and you start doing stupid stuff. Like, that guy is probably chasing me. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Boom. Getting hit by these hollows. I just fell off the ledge. I mean, and this area even has water you can walk in. So there's water. It's good water and bad water. I mean, you can usually tell if it's like ankle high or knee high. It's all right. If it's neck high, you're dead. So not the best start. Let's open up this chest right from the get-go. Let's get some Titanite shards. Always super useful. If you haven't upgraded your weapon, yeah, definitely do so. If you haven't upgraded your armor, maybe hold out. I don't know, maybe put a few points. Soul of Proud Knight. That pillar saved my butt from the flame arrow. Nobody got time for that. Gonna keep going, gonna break some boxes because, you know, rolling is fun. gonna continue. A lot of these guys hide behind archers and they throw those, like, oil pots, which you assume that the oil pots plus flame arrows is gonna be a bad business. I assume that's right. I can't be positive, but it makes sense, especially if they're constantly throwing that combo at you. And why else would the horn bring it? Dudes throw oil. See, like, that's water I rolled in on purpose. You see the ledge, so you know it's okay. That's actually waist high. It's not even knee high. You see my half my cloak or coat is actually wet. Way to go from. That's freaking cool as shit. That you actually know how high up on me is wet. Impressive. So this is kind of an ambush. I like to run that room and deal with that one guy first if you can dispatch him quickly and then deal with the rest as you go. I don't think there's anything really hanging out in this room. It's just kind of a place, you know, you just kind of go every once in a while. No, it's where it's just so that one guy in the ambush can run out. But check out that pirate ship. I've said it maybe once, twice, maybe infinite times, that the environments are beautiful. All right, so we got these dudes, these shadowy-looking, abyss-looking mothers. That guy didn't do so well, but... They remind me of, like, stuff that, like, should be around, like, Manus's place and Dark Souls. Really cool-looking monsters. And they're, like, pure darkness. They have really high reach. They can bleed, which is super obnoxious. If you actually have a torch, they're terrified of fire. So if you can whip out a torch, they'll be afraid. There's a Pharros Lockstone in this area that I actually won't be getting. But it lights up the whole region, which makes those guys a lot easier generally. But there's still some that are in houses. If they don't have access to light, they're not going to be afraid. And just because they're afraid doesn't mean they're completely harmless. They'll still attack you, but not as much and not as frequently and not as aggressively. They'll, like, cover their eyes and back up a lot with their weird, like, long arms. Super creepy. All right. A lot of paths in this area lead to the same place. So even though we just ran up those stairs and then run up those stairs, we're going to come out back up where the stairs were. But you want to check it for items. You want to check it for ambushes. That door looks like a door, but it's not. It's just a bunch of wood planks. It's a trick. House here. I just kind of want to explore all the houses, make sure there's not any items you're missing. Nope, pretty empty. Again, it's just another place enemies could try to ambush you from, is what I think the point is. I'm going to go this... No, this isn't the right way. That's the way we came up. All right, so let's leave. That's the stairway where the first torn guy that's throwing the pots was. He ain't there anymore because he dead. Checking out the environments. That's the bell we want to ring. Yeah, we want to ring a bell because, you know, Dark Souls loves ringing bells. It's a thing you do in this series, so let's go ring a bell. No, but that bell's going to summon the pirate ship we saw that I said looked beautiful in the environment. Because the bell summons the pirate ship, which then allows us to get on the pirate ship and continue with our journey. So that's our plan. So we got some more of these weird long-armed dark dudes. Yeah, they are weird in the fact that sometimes I break their poise really easily. Like right there, broken, keep going, and he dies. Other times their poise doesn't break. And so it's not really consistent. I don't know if I'm just not doing enough damage, like I'm doing far attacks opposed to close attacks. But right there, see? Got the first one in, which broke his poise, and then he attacked me through the second attack, and I killed him. That's super annoying. That's not consistent, but I think it's my position on where I'm hitting them. The smart thing to do would be to hit him once, because the running attack, see, there, that was fine. I don't think his poise was broken, but he just didn't attack me because, I don't know, AI. Emit force, that's what that invader was using, I believe. All right, so we're going to open this door. One of those big freaky things, but it's fine. It can't fit through the door. Oh, wait, it can. Yeah, so he breaks that down. He's got a buddy inside, bleeding. Not good. Got to running. Got to get out of here. Heal up. This guy's almost dead, so let's finish him. Then this guy. I'm thinking that maybe because I'm having this poise issue, oh, it's actually two of them, that if I increase the stone ring, which its purpose is to break enemies' poise, that it might help me with this exact situation since it's like a certain damage problem that I'm thinking will be the solution. So let's try that out. Let's drop the Covenant's silver serpent ring for now and go see if we can break these guys' guard. Separated a little, there he dropped aggro. Just chilling. Bunch. Well, that was a good example. That guy was stunlocked the whole time. What about his buddy? Nope. Didn't work at all. He didn't get his attack on me successfully. Thank you. Thanks. But didn't work out. So that theory was wrong. Proven wrong. Got some weird coat or tattered something there. I didn't even read it. It was too fast. Was just going along with the flow. This guy just chilling in the corner, double hand slap, punch. He attacks through my attack again. Almost kills me, actually. So yeah, we got to mix up how we're killing these guys. I think I'm going to have to do the charge attack, followed by the runaway, followed by a charge attack and single slice. Yeah. So let's go chest that out instead of doing what we're doing. Two chests in here. This cool merchant guy who actually, Gavlan, he's one of the few. I think there's another one, or he might be the only. Not sure on top of my head. But he is the only guy, or maybe another guy, that you can sell items to. So I like to sell duplicates. And he will actually give you souls for giving him the items. Pretty useful. He also sells his poison resist stuff, which I buy all of. Just burn all my souls on it because no one wants to be poisoned. No one needs that. Many things. Ha ha ha. Ga ha. This is a trap chest. It's always trapped, and it usually kills me, even though I know it's trapped. Crossbow, got me twice. Almost murders me. If I had any less health or any less vigor, I would have died there. So, silver talisman. And again, if you break a treasure chest, the wooden one, with the item still inside it, it becomes rubbish. So, you don't want to do that. Maybe if you know what that item is, you can trade the item to the crows and get a better item. So that's a gamble. Never really thought of that. So here is where the bell is. We go up this ladder. That guy almost got me. Didn't notice him. Wasn't really paying that close attention. Oh, man, that guy wasn't paying attention to either. So that guy actually did the dual wheel double strike, which is pretty cool. I like it that the enemies can do that too. So this is the bell. Just trigger it. Ring it. Good. It's the only bell I know that has a lever. And if I watch this, which I guess I don't, lights appear on the pirate ship and it slowly moseys its moseys its way over. And so now we have to go on it via the docks, which which we haven't been to yet. The dock has like this rubble on it, so you actually have to get around the docks to get to the dock part you need. Docks, docks, docks. And then you can continue on. These guys, you can actually backstab. So the fact that I just straight on thrust him is interesting. I still haven't used my new technique on these guys, but we burn him down anyways. Sometimes the straight thrusting is just better, just because it can, if you have enough stamina, you can actually do more damage than the backstab. Liar. No idea what that's talking about. Must have been a previous message there, I'd assume. So we're going to go down here. There's the pirate ship. It's all close by and nearby. I guess those are the same thing, really. These guys sleeping. Those are poison vats. You don't want to hit those. Don't you get poisoned. My sword's at risk. That's bad. If your sword breaks, you have to go to the blacksmith to heal it. If it's at risk, you can see the durability on it in the picture in the bottom left there. I actually find out here that you can roll through those pots, and if you actually don't land in where they break, that you don't get poisoned. There's also a treasure chest in there, actually a really good treasure chest that I skip over at this point. I think I go back and get it, but man, how did I miss that? So I homeward bone there just because I don't want to pay for my weapon to be fixed. That's obnoxious. If you go to a bonfire, though, it instantly repairs all your gear. So you see in the bottom left corner, it's still broken because I didn't actually rest to the bonfire. The home bone just takes you to the bonfire. So if you're a spellcaster or need your items fixed, that's a very important thing to remember, is that you want to use the actual bonfire. So we're going to effigy up again because I'm still feeling the invasion. I don't want to summon other players. Not for this part, or not ever on this playthrough, because I want to show you how it's done by your own. Like a man. I don't know. That's not true. See here, and also by using the effigy, I can continue trying to attempt to invade people. Failure. I'm getting shot by the arrow, the archer. I forgot about the sleeping dude. I'm glad I remembered about the sleeping dude the very first time we came across here. Talked a little crap. And then forgot about him for the rest on. So that's cool. See, this is the docks, but we need to be on the other side. That guy actually charged, waited, and charged. So good on his AI. I'm getting flanked here, playing pretty bad. I'm half covered in oil, so I assume that means I don't want to get a flame arrow right now. Stabby, stabby. Burn these guys down, try eliminating one at a time, you know. Whatever the message would say. Stabby, stabby. Still covered in oil, or whatever that soot is. Pretty obnoxious. Let's deal with this arrow dude. Let's try not to get hit with the fire, because, well, oil and fire don't mix well, or mix too well. I don't really... You know what I mean. Boom, blaze. Again, I like to eliminate this guy and let the others come to me. Play my game, not play their game. Double scimitar, bro. See, I thought I was like setting that up so he would run in and I'd stab him. But instead, Rei II's like, you know what? I'm going to hit this wall and let him slash me. I think that's a much better strategy. I disagree, but, you know, two minds. You're not always going to have the same. You're not always going to think the same. I don't know what that guy was doing. He was trying to run away. It was enough to him to stab me in the gut, but not before he, or before or after he died. More shadowy creatures. I didn't need to aggro this guy, but I did anyways. But yeah, see, he doesn't want any part of that light. He's not unaggroed. He's just refusing to go near the light. So I'm going to like try to invade the world of the guilty right in his face. But of course, there's no guilty to be found. So we're going to stab him. Roll out. And then, oh, he still slashes me. Still go for the, and then go for the double slab. I think we're going to do for the running stab in the future. I think it's a better strategy. Like the longsword has that stab and not the slash on the run attack. So yeah, you can see the docks on the other side of where I actually want to be. But we got to go up here. I get lost in this area still. I'm still not super familiar with everything. This guy's here. He has a puppy with him. He had a puppy with him. We're going to keep archers. Okay, that arrow went through my head, so I don't blame her for staggering. I literally broke your table. Yo, stop sleeping. Get up. Stop being lazy. Come kill me. Come attempt to kill me. Double scimitar, bros. Get stabbed in the gut. Sit down. All right. to keep climbing up. Sometimes forget just exactly how tough I am. Treasure chest here. Hopefully I actually notice this one, unlike the last one. I think I do. I'm looking kind of right at it, but hell, that don't mean crap. Dark Souls. I've been running past chests left and right. Chest on chest. Opening up, not trapped, not mimicked, but inside is repair powder and a titanite shard. This area is really bad on durability. Look, I homeboned back and I'm already at like half durability on this longsword. What is going on? That is a gate that will open a slight shortcut. And that summon sign in the ground was not actually a player. It was like Lucille, the swashbuckler chick, Lucille or whatever her name is. That wasn't where I wanted to roll. I'm just taking more damage, doing bad stuff, getting in the face of this archer who does or does not. See me? Shoots me point blank in the face. I don't even stab him. I like fire in my eyes. It's cool. It's healthy. It's glorious. Pick up their armor. Don't want to use too many Estus Flasks because my idea here is I want to beat the boss. But, you know, we'll see how that works out. Dark Souls 2. So we're back here. I did a big, huge roundabout for absolutely no reason. Just because I like to waste my time. So I figured, you know, hey, you probably like your time wasted too. I don't really know your thoughts on that. I don't want to fall in that other place I fell before because I actually did a lot of damage. I even got the roll off there and I still took a lot of damage. So not ideal situations here. So I guess we got to go all the way around. I'm going to get ambushed because I didn't kill the other guy in that room. There's one guy. And there's the other guy. Missed that first attack, attacked the stair, but keep going anyways. Why not? That guy's backing off. He doesn't want any part of this. Even though he's double guarding, he's still not using a shield, so he does not have 100% block resist. So that's a thing. So just stabbing him regardless of his stance, you'll still deal a good amount of damage. Again, if you have fire or whatever, these guys are a little scared of you. All right, so this is my new strategy. Run up, hit him, break his guard a little, then go in and go for the double stab. Even that way, if he goes through his poise and he swings at me, he will go down. To back up. I could have gone there, but let's not be too crazy. Let's do it this way. Down goes the weird shadow beast. Again, take your time, play it cool, use a torch if you want to, if you have to, if you have enough swing time or whatever. All right, at this point I forget where we're supposed to fall, so I'm looking for the right ledge. I think I get lost again because, you know, it's what I'm good at. This is the ledge we want, this one with this corpse here. Not on that side, but turn around, Rei. Yeah, there we go. This is the side we want. Land on here, boom. All right. New area. That's the summon. This is the... I actually tried to open the door. I didn't even see the chain because, as I said before, those chains are impossible for me to see. I'm going to summon her because she's an NPC. I'm all for NPCs in this playthrough, just not players, because I want it something that a player offline or someone doesn't have a super powerful guy overleveled or underleveled but with super gear to help you with. I want to always keep these options. Or if, like, a million years down the line, people aren't playing Dark Souls 2 anymore, you still have these guys. They're always here to help. They are programmed. And I'm actually surprised by her AI. I thought she'd run through the house. I didn't think she'd fall off ledges like I did. So, again, good job from Soft. That's pretty awesome. So I got my buddy, my swashbuckler buddy. These guys are being lazy again. I like how that guy was like doing the mime thing with the leaning his head on the table, even though the table was completely gone, because I don't want them to have tables. Let her clean this up. Or not. I don't want to deal with the poison. I'd rather her deal with the poison. That was cool. That was like a butter of her sword, or maybe it was the enemy's poison, but our swashbuckler pal isn't. So I'm just going to finish this. I'm tired of this. Hey, I'm going to get this treasure chest that's really good and really important that I skipped over before. Yay. And why is it really good? Escus Flash Shard. What else could... Oh, Why would I do that? I spend so much time letting her fight and not stabbing the pots. So after I get the item, what do? I roll into the pot. Makes no sense. I use the item to clean up the poison because I want to beat the boss now, or so I think. So I want to save those Estus. I don't want to have to heal through poison. That's pretty awful. Continue falling. Go from all the way to the top to the bottom to get this item. The water won't kill you here. Human effigy, life gem times 2. Can't go wrong with that. It's always good. There's always room for Jell-O. She's following. Now we're on the other side of the docks. So there's an NPC we want to talk to, a friend guy that will teach us spells. And since we have our int up to 10, he will actually talk to us. If your int isn't 10, he has nothing to do with you. And I remember I want this character, I want Rei 2 to be a Spellblade character. So we are going to go buy magic weapon. But wait, where'd this bro come from? What the? I'm stuck in dialogue. Well, she just fell off to the water and died. So that guy literally killed me because I was in the dialogue of the mage guy. You see, he's still talking to me. And then I'm dead. Menu. I was totally locked up. I couldn't do anything. So don't let that guy ambush you. So here we're back. I'm still hollow. Well, I'm hollow from dying. My swashbuckler buddy's not here. Pretty obnoxious. We're going to put our hood up just to have that little extra padding. We didn't kill his archer because I ran mostly here. Dodging arrows that we can't see. Not fun. Stop. All right, so we need a magical weapon. Let's buy that. 2,000 souls. That's nothing. There's other spells you can see real quick. I would be happy to show you, but this archer's being a total tool. Let's buy the catalyst because I don't start one. I didn't start with one because I'm actually a swordsman, not a mage of any sort. So we got the beginner catalyst now. We got the spell we wanted the whole game. But we can't use it because we have to rest at a bonfire to tune. I bet it was these two guys that ambushed me. Because, how do you like it? You get pushed in the water. Ugh. Almost dove off because why wouldn't I? Stabby. So I bet those are the guys that ambushed me when I was talking to the mage guy. But what jerks. Because they weren't there that time. That's why I was kind of hanging back, playing it cool. Hoping that I would see their pathing, but there was no path to be seen. So that's what we did. Now we are actually on board the pirate ship. Stab these archers. Always try to get rid of the archers first. Try stabbing it back. Here we go. Some more duders. Attacking a shield. That's why I'm doing such a little damage. Still throwing those pots at me. Yeah, I think I saw another guy appear on the dock. So, got some adds to this party. Getting hit with the oil and the fire. So, good times. I'm like, screw it. This guy's got to go. He's being super obnoxious. You archers, pain in the butt. Draw your sword. Okay. I was just kidding. Just kidding, bro. All right. Dodge, roll. Get out of here with these attacks. We're going to have to Estus up, so that means we only have one Estus for the boss. Not an ideal situation, but you know how it goes. A little stabby, a little dodgy. And end scene. Okay, so they're dead. No more adds. It's just me and the boss now. Boss is in the pirate ship. I don't know if he's like the first mate or the captain or... I don't know how hollow ships work, man. I thought hollow were insane. How do they even operate boats? So many questions. I don't know. So let's go down. Those look like chests, but they're not. We're going to get in a little bit of water here, which is just enough to be obnoxious. And this fog gate will bring us to Le Boss. All right, here we go. Flexile Sentry. He's one of these dual split guys where you will find one later in the game, not as a boss, and I fight him basically the same. Because I have such high mobility, all I do to beat this guy is run up to him, let him swing, roll away, and then if he doesn't have a follow through, just give him a little stab. If he has two follow throughs, wait for those to go, like right there, and give him a little stab. If you get there quick enough, give him two stabs. There again, just bait it out and run forward and give him a stab. Doing 185 with, I think, a +4/+5 longsword. It's not the greatest, but because I haven't really updated my dex or strength that much, but it's doing its job. I don't know if this guy has a ranged attack. I'm not really even sure what the scimitar half of him does. It's probably something very similar. But yeah, just bait it out and swing. Punish him. I actually break his poise there. Swing. Oh, he actually got me. Apparently, he does bleed damage. Swing. I just go for it. And that's it. You finish him, and you get his soul, the Flexile Sentry soul. And that's it. And you continue your boat ride. Best of luck with that, guys. Go up. There's a ladder here. And I think there's actually items in this room, but I'm an idiot and just jump on this thing, and it's a pain in the butt to get to, because, yeah, sure, it's going to take me somewhere, but it doesn't take me on the boat. It just, for some reason, I'm here on a dock back in the Lost Bastille. So that's a thing. So if those items were any good, my bad. Don't do what I did. Turn around and check those out. Don't be an idiot. Why is there so much blood here? What happens? Is this like a high invasion zone? Because there's literally visions of bloodstains. That guy is absolutely right. There are no enemies here. None. Praise the sun, though. Praise the sun, question mark? I mean, yeah, praise the moon? That seems hypocritical. But yeah, beautiful, beautiful shot there. First time I actually got to this area, I came in from here. Which is, you can get here from the Lost Bastille. This isn't like a back door. I mean, it is a back door in a way, but it's not exactly a back door. You can get through it through normal means. But yeah, I came down. I saw that pirate ship. I saw the dock. I did not know how to get to it. I was like, I don't understand. And like, I don't even think I suicide. I didn't see any possible way of getting on that ship. And I made the right choice because there isn't any possible way to get on the ship. You just have to deal with it. Sort of Lost Bastille, there's a bonfire right there, yeah. So let's grab that real quick. And let's go back to Majula. And that's it for today. For all, everyone, I hope this helped. Take care.